Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel, welcome to a new video and technically the first video in our new home. We moved in a little over a week ago now as I'm filming this, and to say it has been chaotic and stressful would be the understatement of the year, I would say. So yeah, it's been a little bit of a test in time, but I feel like we're coming out the other side, so I thought I would pick up the camera. Don't get me wrong, I did pick up the camera and do like little bits and pieces here and there when we've been out and about and doing stuff. I don't know if I'm going to put that in this vlog or if I'm going to do a vlog before this one, just to make my workload even more. But right now I've got no internet and I've also got no computer because we can't set up the computer desk yet because we are trying to sell some furniture which is in the room where the computer desk is going to go. So it's all a little bit to and fro at the minute, but we're in, that's the main thing. Nelly's room is pretty much set up. She's got a cot in there and there's a little bit of space, not that she's played on the floor yet or anything, but yeah, she's quite happy. As you can tell, oh, she's having a little nap. I'm just keeping an eye on the room because that room gets quite warm, so I'm just keeping an eye on the temperature, but she's been asleep for about an hour now, so not too bad. And yeah, I thought I would pop on and say hello and go from there really. I'm probably going to try and do this into a little bit of a weekly vlog, maybe just do some weekly vlogs coming up, because obviously I'm going to be filming content that you're not necessarily going to see straight away until I can get set up. We are hopefully getting the internet on Wednesday, so I'm hopeful that then I can clear the backlog that little bit, which might actually do me a favour, because I have decided that this year I'm going to do Vlogmas again. So yeah, at least hopefully that will probably take me up to Nelly there, to be fair, because I've literally got so much content right now. I can't even work out in what order it's meant to go up, and yeah, plus obviously I've got some house content that I want to share with you. So yeah, I would imagine that would take me right up to Vlogmas. So if there's anything you want to see during Vlogmas, I have already booked a couple of events, so I will obviously be vlogging those, and there'll be the standard put my decorations up. I really want to put my autumn decorations up, but I'll show you this room in a minute. I'm not going to do a full house tour at the minute, just because it's a mix of our belongings and somebody else's belongings, so I kind of don't want to show off too much right now until it's all ours basically. So there'll be no like full house tour or anything. I think I'm just gonna follow the trend, if you like, and just do room by room as and when either I'm in it and we're talking like now, or when we like renovate a room and stuff, because we've already renovated one room which I'm pleased about. It looks amazing. So at some point I will show you the before and after. I'm just wanting to do a few finishing touches to that before I show you. But yeah, I'm so excited to be here. I'm so excited that I've got like a front garden, a back garden, which to some people might sound really strange, but just being able to actually get out, like me and Nelly have been out most days, even just for a walk, like just getting out and some fresh air, and even like just getting out and literally standing in the garden for like 2 minutes and breathing in fresh air. Obviously I could do that at the flat, but it kind of wasn't the same, and as for going in and out, it was just horrendous trying to get the pushchair up and down the stairs. My pushchair comes in two parts, so like I'd take the wheels down, then I'd have to climb back up to put the other bit down, then you've got to go back up to get like your change bag and bits and bobs that you need to take, and then I've got to go back up to get Nelly to put her in the pram, and then I had to go back up and lock the door, so it was just more hassle than it was worth a lot of the time for like a 15-minute walk, because it was a small place that we were living and there wasn't really much to do, so it wasn't even worth leaving the house or the flat. So yeah, that was that. But whereas now I've already walked into town and back, I've walked out to a retail park and back, we've gone for walks around the block, like so much better, which I'm really, really happy about. So yeah, that is that. An update on Trix, she is doing really, really well now. She's got a little bit of a scar on one side where one of the main punch wounds was, but the other ones you can't see because of her fur. She's back to her demanding self. If you happen to eat something near her, she wants it. Really cuddly again, just yeah, back to normal. Which I'm really, really pleased about. Unfortunately, the whole saga with surrounding like vet bills and the person to blame and various things like that is still an ongoing case at the minute. So I can't talk about that, and to be honest, I probably wouldn't anyway. But the main thing for me is that she's doing really, really well. I haven't got over my fear yet of taking her for a walk, especially in the area, because obviously the attack happened a couple of streets away from where Trix lives with my mum and dad. And yeah, like I really want to take her out for a walk because that's what we were doing. Because obviously, Nelly and Trixie, it's not that they don't get on. I don't know where this cough suddenly come from. It's not that they don't get on, but Trix isn't the best dog to be around kid young babies, I would say. So obviously I watch her like a hawk, she's always on the lead. And it's not even that she would go to attack her, because she wouldn't, she just barks. And then by barking and barking and barking, she stresses herself out. Nelly tries winding her up, because when Trix does stop barking, Nelly makes a noise to make Trix bark. So you just end up with a headache. Like, that's the only issue with it. It's not, you know, by all means I wouldn't leave them together, but it's not like a safety issue like that. It's more of a like for my sanity. So like before the attack, we were like getting Trix and taking her out with Nelly in the pram, Trix beside the pram, walking like for half an hour or so. Trix would love it, I'd love it, Nelly loved the fresh air, Ash just come along for the ride. And that was fine, but I just can't bring myself to even walk in the area at the minute. Which I know sounds really stupid, because I wasn't actually there when the attack took place, but I think it's just, I probably just need to get on and do it. It's like when you fall off a bike, I guess, you know, I just need to get out there, do it, and kind of in my mind put it as that was a fluke, and yeah, it shouldn't have happened, but it did. But yeah, right now I can't get past that, and I can't take her for a walk. I just can't do it. Like, to the point that I think to myself, right, tomorrow I might go around and, you know, suggest we take her for a walk and stuff. And then during that night, I'll wake up in a cold sweat, and by the morning, I'm just like, I can't physically do it. So definitely something that I need to work on. But as for Trix, yeah, she's absolutely hunky dory, I guess you would say. Whether there's any lasting damage, I don't know. And I don't think that's anything that we're ever going to really know. But yeah, in herself, she seems okay, and that's the main thing for me. Update on Nelly. She's like aged overnight again. Yesterday she started commando crawling, I think they call it. So not full crawling, she still can't push herself up on her hips. However, she is making full use of the front room. And she's definitely coming on leaps and bounds now that we have a flat floor. If you didn't see my flat tour ages and ages ago, then you wouldn't know, but the flat we were living in, the floor was insanely all over the place. It was like a 500-year-old building, and yeah, I think you could see it in the floor, like nothing was level. And I think that impacted Nelly and her development quite a bit, because even when it come to sitting, she was having to balance extra hard because it was either downhill or uphill. It was not ever flat. Whereas like now she's having a whale of a time. So yeah, that is that. I think that is a little update on everybody. Ash is starting a new job. This is his third job now. He was meant to have a job that was relocating with us, and then that fell through. So that job ended. He went for another one last Wednesday. He did 3 days and then it just wasn't for us. The money wasn't that great. It was a lot of traveling to get to and there, so that was depleting the money as well. And yeah, we just, the long and the short of it is we couldn't afford it, which is a shame because he liked the job, but the money and the hours just weren't the right thing for us. So he started another job this morning, which he says that is going quite well, although it might still be long hours. Which, yeah, we'll just have to see. Like, I don't know if he'll stick at it or not. I really hope he does, even for a little while. Would be good just to have some normality, I'm not gonna lie. But yeah, so fingers crossed he gets on with it and it's all working well. But other than that, he's okay. Obviously, like with me, it's been super stressful. And I think it's definitely taken its toll on the pair of us, but we are coming through the other side. Things are looking a little bit more normal. I just need to get rid of this furniture and then can kind of really set up how we want to set up. So yeah, it's not too bad. I do need to go, I have put it on Marketplace, but it's not happening. So I do need to go to the local furniture like charity shop thing and see if they want it, because if not, I'm just going to chop it up and take it to the tip. But I didn't want to drag Nelly out, because right now we've got the effects of a hurricane or something from America and the weather isn't brilliant. So I don't want to like drag Nelly out in that, to be fair. And it's a long way to walk, and if you're wet and cold and miserable, it's just not fun. So I might do that later in the week, with the aim that hopefully it'll be gone by the weekend, fingers crossed. Yeah, we shall see. So it doesn't look great at the minute, but this is kind of what I'm working with. This is our front room. I'm currently sat on my sofa, which is the same sofa. Excuse the mess of it, because we did get it secondhand. But normally I've got throws on, but I haven't found the box with them in, and they could do with being cleaned really anyway. So yeah, we're just living life with this sofa at the minute. But yeah, as you can see, it's like a pretty good sized room. I'd imagine some people probably use them as like living room, diner. So we've got like the TV over there. I've still got, as you can see, boxes everywhere. Basically, from where that wardrobe to across, from there down this way was literally a sea of boxes when we moved in. There was no space whatsoever. We had like the sofa was crammed down in here when we first moved in, and yeah, it was just super stressful. So thankfully we've got like a little bit of living space sorted out now. There is a lot in the attic that I still need to sort out, but the stuff we didn't need like urgently has just gone up there for now. So yeah, but it's a bit messy anyway because Nelly was playing with all her toys. Like I say, she literally takes up the whole room. She's loving life with it at the minute. I think it might be time to maybe pack the play gym away, because she's not really showing an interest in that anymore. She's too long for it, and I just think to myself, I could probably get away with packing it away, and that would like free up a little bit of space. But our plan is for this to kind of be like obviously our living area, and then down there is going to hopefully be Nelly's play area, so it's not fully encroaching on. I don't mind her being up here by all means, but just like her jumperoo and things like that, and even the high chair can just like shove down that end, and like be out of the way, so that then when it's night time, sort of evening time, like it's all pushed out the way, you know. Just notice she's face down. I think she's got her head to the side slightly. Apologies about that. So yeah, that is kind of the plan. My only concern is that I've, oh, if I can get up. But yeah, as you can see, the jumper really takes up quite a bit, but it is able to stay up. I haven't got to keep taking it down, which is a major plus. But yeah, my only concern about the play area is that's the only place that the glass cabinet could realistically fit. Which is obviously a worry, because I don't want her to break anything. So I'll have to just be very cautious about what I put there. There is a radiator behind this unit. This is one of the units that's going, but there is a radiator behind there. So again, I don't realistically want furniture in front of it if I can help it. And then just to show you out in the hallway, I've got this toy box for her. It just needs a bit of a scrub up and clean. This was actually my toy box when I was little. Apologies if you don't like clowns. I probably should have mentioned that beforehand. But yeah, so that is then going to go hopefully in that space once those boxes are gone. So that'll be like extra toy storage. To be fair, there's two boxes that have literally got Nelly's toys in, as well as like everything that's on my floor. And I don't want to show anything. Everything that's on my floor, and also the two toy boxes that are exploding there as well. But yeah, like, I think it will work well in this one. I don't know if Ash put them in there or not. Yeah, so in this one, I'm hoping it will organise a little bit better, but I'm hoping this can be like our games cupboard and things, because yeah, we've been playing Frustration for the last like few days and really enjoying it. So yeah, I'm hoping that will work out quite well. It's got two drawers as well, which at the minute has got birthday presents in and Christmas presents as and when I'm finding them. Yeah, so that is kind of where we're at. Like I say, it's a little bit chaotic and I don't really know where to start. I have cleaned the kitchen a little bit today, and I've also cleaned the toilet, like downstairs toilet. Basically, our bathroom is too small to fit a toilet in, so the toilet is downstairs. And we've got a bath and shower upstairs, which is not always ideal, but it was that or lose like a bedroom, and we didn't want to do that, so we can cope with it. It's just like getting used to it, you know. It's just that thing of like before bed going to the toilet and things like that, and just like not leaving it to the last minute, as I've done a couple of times and thought, oh my gosh. But yeah, it's just like getting used to stuff, I think, more than anything. And yeah, so that is pretty much it. I'm gonna just tidy up in here, I think, and then no, my light Nelly will be awake anyway. So yeah, come and join us for the week, see what we get up to. Spoiler alert, it's probably going for a load of boxes. But yeah, I hope you enjoy this vlog. Nelly, Nelly. Hello, hello, good morning. This is future editor me just jumping on, because it's been a little while since I started this vlog and some of the clips don't make much sense, so I'm gonna end up, I think, just popping up here and there throughout this video, and I'll explain why there's been a little bit of a gap at the end. But the last clip you've just seen of the clothes, I put it in and then I thought, no one's actually gonna know what on earth I'm on about, because I've obviously thought I've spoken about it and I haven't. But basically, the clothes I'm sharing are things that I picked up in a bundle, and yeah, I don't really know why I just showed the coat, but it was cute, but I haven't kept it. I'm a little bit traditional like that. I prefer to have like pinks and things like that that are brighter color when it comes to a coat, especially once Nelly starts moving, because I feel like the navy is just going to make her blend in too much. I quite want her to be like brightly coloured so that you can see her, kind of thing. But I did keep a lot of the other stuff that was in the bundle, but unfortunately I didn't film it and now I don't know where it's to, so apologies about that. But yeah, so I will just pop up here and there. The next clips you're going to see are actually from the carnival. I'm hoping I don't get copyright for it, because there were some really, really amazing floats, and it was a good evening. It was nice to be back and just enjoy something that I've always enjoyed. So yeah, I hope you enjoy the next clips. I
Thank you.
So then the next clips you're going to see are actually after a post-swim with Nelly and Mum. We went to a local seaside resort which opens their pool for the majority of the year, and it's just known to be a little bit warmer than the pools in this area. And obviously, I don't want Nelly to get too cold or anything. And to be honest, if she gets too cold, she'll just scream and not enjoy it. So that would be money wasted. So we took the little journey to go to the seaside and have a little swim. Nelly absolutely enjoyed it, as I knew she would. And I'm definitely going to try and make it more of a regular thing. But yeah, it was just really lovely. And then we stopped off because they've got a little cafe there, so we stopped off and had some lunch, which was really nice. Nelly was smiling at everybody, being really nosy, listening to their conversations. I don't know where she gets that from. And yeah, people were making a fuss around and stuff, so that was nice. Oh, yeah, isn't it? You gonna smell now, though? Oh, you've got mashed potato. Just realised that as I was editing those last little clips, I am wearing the same t-shirt. I promise I do change it. Yeah, it's just comfortable and I love it. But yeah, so like I say, that was really nice. We had jacket potatoes. I went for coronation chicken because that is one of my all-time favourite toppings. But I have to say, it was so spicy. I really didn't enjoy it. It made my nose run. Which doesn't normally happen. I definitely think they put like chili powder or something on the top. I don't do spice by any means. So yeah, it wasn't one that I enjoyed, sadly, but I'm glad I tried it. But then that kind of set the precedent of the next few days, which is the reason why I have got this like sporadic vlog that I just kind of need to piece together to get it up and then hopefully start afresh. But basically, I became ill. I woke up that morning not feeling very well, but I still wanted to go swimming because it's for Nelly. You know, if it was just me, I would have been like, nah, we'll leave it. But like, I kind of said to Nelly that I wanted to do it, and obviously, I know she doesn't understand these things, but I don't want to be that parent that says we're going to do something and then don't end up doing stuff all the time. So I kind of still wanted to go, so I brushed it aside. And then after that coronation chicken, like the journey back, which took about 30 minutes or so, I just kept feeling worse and worse. I was sneezing, I was coughing, and I could just tell I was coming down with something. So that kind of put me out of action for a few days. And then sadly, Nelly caught it from me, as did Ash, which was kind of inevitable. You know, we live together, there's every chance that we're all going to get it. But it was Nelly's first cold. She'd done so well to get so far in her little life without being ill in the slightest, but I think this just knocked her for six. And come Friday morning slash Thursday night, you know, like early hours, we noticed that Nelly wasn't breathing properly. So we phoned for medical assistance and had to go out to the hospital. They did obs on Nelly for several hours, and she had spiked in temperature and there was various other things, but thankfully we managed to get it all under control and she could come home after a few hours sat in A&E waiting room. And yeah, just came home and I gave her lots of cuddles and she'd fall asleep on me for like 3-4 hour period. She just want cuddles. And I know it's really mean to say, but Nelly really isn't a cuddly baby. She never has been. She's very much I'll have a cuddle, but that's it. Like after 2 seconds, I don't want you anymore. So as much as it was really sad and horrible to see her poorly, like it did fill my cup to actually be able to have cuddles with her and her want me rather than pushing me away, which is what she normally does. But thankfully, she is on the mend. I'm on the mend. Ash is just getting over the last little bit of it. So yeah, hopefully we'll be fighting fit very soon. But that is why there was no video on Friday. And that is why this vlog ended up being all over the place, because I just wasn't feeling it. And then the stress over the weekend with Nelly, it wasn't the one. And like I said in the post, Nelly and my family comes first always. So yeah, I hope you understand as to why there was no video. And then it brings me on to the last few clips, because I am going to end this video shortly. You'll be pleased to know you won't have to see my face any longer today. Unless you want to, obviously, by which means subscribe and you can see all of my vlogs. But we managed to get out yesterday, which was really lovely, to just go for a walk along the river, get out and see Trix, which, funny enough, at the start of this video, I said that I didn't want to walk with her. And do you know what? I got over it. I can't say I'm at ease in the area where the attack was to, but yesterday I had the lead the whole time and I didn't feel spooked or anything. I was on top of it. I knew where dogs were too, and it was that fine balance of trying to let her still be social but understand when we need to go or when it's not the right dog for her. So she said hello to a couple of dogs and she was all right with them. A spaniel ran past, Nelly bowled her over, which she wasn't impressed about, I have to say. And we did meet an Alsatian, which is the type of dog that attacked her. So I did keep her on a short leash for that, and I'm glad I did, because she got very defensive very quickly, which I felt a bit sorry for the lady in a sense, because she was looking as if to say, like, you've said hello to everyone else's dog, so why not mine? But I just wanted to be better safe than sorry. But the walk itself was really lovely. I was going to film the rest of that day, but to be honest, we were so tired after the walk that we literally vegged out and didn't really do much. So I hope you enjoy these last few clips, and please remember to like and subscribe, and I promise you normal service is going to resume very, very soon, hopefully on Friday, because I'm all up to date with my videos, in case you haven't noticed. So yeah, it will be more back to real time for the moment. As I did say at the beginning of this video, I will be doing Vlogmas, so make sure you're subscribed so you don't miss that. And in the meantime, I am also hoping to do something new on my channel, and that is to do a gift guide, just sharing some gift ideas for Christmas for various people. So if that is something that you would like to watch, then again, hit that subscribe button and then you won't miss that video. But yeah, enjoy these last clips and I'll see you very soon. You're getting tired. Because you could hear it.